Good morning to all of you. Now we are going to talk about how we are going to send SMS from one device to another device. So here we are going to present the code for the SMS. In the last lecture, we have seen how we are going to make the connection with the Bluetooth devices. In the similar fashion, we have to make the connection for the SMS also, because Bluetooth device is also a hardware device, and sending SMS from the SIM card is also connection with the hardware device. So first we have to make the connection in the Android manifest. So let's check the Android manifest file. Now here we have to make the permission. So users permission android:name android.permission.sendSMS. So first we have to make the permission for sending the SMS. So this is very important. If you are not make the entry in the Android manifest file, the SMS will not be sent. So this is a very important task. First we have to make the permission for the send SMS. Now once you make the entry in the Android manifest file, we have to check the controls. So this is the activity, that is, this is the XML file. When you check the XML file, we have taken that one text box for the phone number, second for the what SMS you want to write, and second and third, that is the button for sending the SMS. So I have taken a linear layout. So in the linear layout, I have taken fill parents, that is, I want to match the screen adjust automatically. Now here we have to make the orientation as a vertical. Now first text box I have taken, first label, not the first text view, that is, enter phone number. So here I have taken a label, enter the phone number. Now in front of that I have taken this as a phone number. Now android:phone number is true, I have taken this as a polytechnic phone number. So here is the ID, edit text, phone number. So this is the first text box to take the input for the phone number. Second text box, that is, to enter the SMS, what SMS we want to send to a particular number. Now this will be the number. On this number, the SMS written on this text box is going to send. Now here I have taken the multi-line text box. So edit text, and here is the button. When you click on the button, the SMS is going to send. So this is the button send. Now we are going to check what the code for the Java file. Now here is the Java file. Now here is the code for the SMS. We have taken buttons. So this is the control button. This is actually a class. Edit text, it is a class, and it is also a class. We have taken the variables or the object of these classes. After that, there is a method, that is onCreate method. Now in the onCreate method, we have to initialize the layout first. So set content view, it is a method to initialize a layout. So R, that is a resource dot layout dot activity underscore SMS. So this is the code for to initialize the layout. After that, we have taken button. Now button is find view by ID. So R dot ID dot button send. So I have to initialize this button. Now once you initialize the buttons and the text boxes, on the button click listener we have to write a code. So button dot set on click listener, it is a method we have called. Now the interface is on click listener. We have to implement this interface, and this interface has a method on click. So we have to implement this on click method. Now in the on click method, we have to write a code. First we have to get the values from the text boxes. So text, phone number, it is a ID, it is a actually variable. So this is the ID, edit text phone. Now this variable has this ID as a variable, text phone number. Now this text phone number dot get text dot to string. So that whatever the string I'm going to use or I'm going to put, that I'm going to store in the phone number. Second, that is string SMS. So in the SMS I have to put up the whatever the message we have written on the text box. So these two variables I have taken. After that, that is try and catch block. Now for the exception handling, we are going to use try and catch block. So in the try block, this is the SMS manager. SMS is equal to SMS manager dot get default. Now this get default is nothing but whatever the default values of the SMS manager class have, that is I'm going to store on the variable SMS manager. So get default, it is also static variable. In the previous lecture also of the Bluetooth, we have used get defaults Bluetooth. So that in that case also, whatever the default values of the Bluetooth are there, we have used there. In the similar way, whatever the default values for the SMS are there, I'm going to use that. So SMS manager is equal to SMS manager dot get default. So this is the static method present in the class SMS manager. Now the next is SMS manager dot send text message. Now this is the method I have to call. Now I want to pass the variables like a phone number. So this is the phone number I want to pass. Second is SA address that I am not needed, I am kept as a null. Second I value that is SMS, what SMS I want to pass. So this string SMS I want to pass. Then send intent that I want to keep as a null. Delivery intent, I don't want a delivery intent, so I kept as a null. So these are the variables I have kept. First, so the most important things needed are that is phone number and the SMS. Remaining variables you can keep null or keep empty as it is. After that, once you send SMS, I want to make the toast that make test SMS sent, and this should be in the long. Otherwise, if there is any exception in the try block, that should be handled in the catch block. So in the catch block, I have written get application context e dot get message and toast dot length long and dot show. So like this, we have written the toast message in the catch block. So this was the code for the SMS. So this is a very simple code. Now suppose I want to run this code in the Android manifest. I want to change this with the SMS. So SMS file is going to run it. Now I'm going to run this file. Now here I want to write a phone number, and whatever the phone number to whom you are going to send the SMS, that phone number I want to write over here. And here I want to write the SMS. And once you put up the SMS, suppose I want to write 2 3 4 7 6, so like this. And when you click on the send, the SMS will be sent. This code is already tested. You can get the APK file and you can test on your mobile also. The SMS is going to send it. So this was the code for how we are going to send the SMS. So if you have any doubts, any questions, you can put on the comments. Thank you.